deed on the cross. Go
and tell the whole world.
Set in the cross. Deliverer. He's a savior. He's our God.
Christ, if you don't have any family inheritance to inherit, you can inherit the inheritance of Jesus.
His forgiveness of our sins.
If there is no provision for forgiveness, without meaning to.
You have salvation in Christ Jesus. You have given your life to Christ. Your Father brings salvation for you.
I come your way with the words of comfort while we are waiting for our Lord Jesus Christ. Stay tuned. Hallelujah. The world.
Thank you for precious ones who are viewing us all over the world. We pray that your word will speak to every soul, every spirit, every individual. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we bind demons and evil spirits and powers of Satan that arise against us as we speak forth your word. We pray that God, you will give the people attention so they will hear your word and know you and understand you so they can serve you all the days of their lives. In Jesus' name, amen. Yes, today we're talking about God has given us life. God has given us life. You know, when we talk about God, we're talking about the Almighty, the Theos, the God who created the heavens and the earth, El Shaddai, the Adonai. We look at 1 John chapter 5. Now we're going to read from 1 John chapter 5, verse number 11 to verse 13. Now let's hear the word of God. This is the record that God has given to us eternal life, and this life is in his hand. He that hath the Son of life, and he that hath not the Son of God hath not life. Verse 13. These things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that ye may know that ye have eternal life, and that ye may believe on the name of the Son of God. Hallelujah. So right now, what the Bible tells us here in verse 11 is that God is giving us a record. Now the record means it's something that God has already predetermined and established, that every human being has life. We're talking about the life of God. Now he says that God has given to us eternal life. That is Zoe, a life that begins and goes with God. Eternal life is the God kind of life, is the life of God. We have the human life, which is the temporal life, but we have the eternal life. The eternal life is the life of God. When you get hold of eternal life, which is the life of God, it is a life that does not just end when you die. No, eternal life actually begins to have greater expression after death. If you have eternal life, you might not really enjoy it now until you die. When you die, after death, you begin to experience the eternal life in its totality. Right now, so many of us have eternal life, but we seem to live like ordinary human beings. But after death, we see it. There are some people, too, that seems to have life, which is actually not life. The Bible says that you have a name that you are alive, yet you're dead. You know, you might have a name or be popular or famous, but if you don't have the life of God in you, which is called the Zoe, you might not actually have God's kind of life. When we talk about that life, we're talking about the life of God. It's a life that only God have. A life that continues till infinity. That means a life without ending. So eternal life, in other words, can also be used to express in the words everlasting life. And that's the kind of life God has given to us. But not many of us have that kind of life. The reason is that not many of us have received it. God has made that life available, but you might not have that life. Now, if you can have that life, you need to receive the carrier of the life. He said, God has given to us eternal life, and this life is in his hand. 1 John chapter 5, verse 11. So the eternal life is in the Son of God. If you want to have eternal life, you need to have the Son of God in your life. God has given to us life. Now, what is the need for life? The need for life is that human beings are death. Satan gave us death. Satan killed us. And the Bible tells us that when we sinned against God, that was death. In Genesis chapter 3, the Lord said to the children of the Adam and Eve that when they eat the forbidden fruit, they die. Now Satan comes and says, you shall not surely die. You know, so they ate it, but that was death. Now that death was a separation from God, because God is the life. So when you are separated from God, it means you're separated from life. Being separated from life, you're connected to death. So from that day, human beings begin to die. God gave us life, but we did not appreciate the life that God gave us. And the reason we did not appreciate it, because we did not live to obey God. Now, wherever you are listening to me or watching me, I want you to understand that God loves you and God cares for you. He wants to bless your life and change your story. He wants to make a new life out of you. But if you really are ready for that kind of life, it's the life of God, you need to receive the Son. He said, this life is in His Son. Verse 12, 1 John chapter 5, verse what? Verse 12, the Bible says, he that hath the Son of life, and he that hath not the Son of God hath not life. He said, if you have the Son, that means if you have Jesus in your life, you have life. And he says, if you don't have Jesus in your life, you don't have life. That means that you might have a name that you are alive, but you're not actually alive in the very presence of God. Well, when we talk about the life that God has to offer, you actually are dead in God's presence. He is the life giver. He gives His children life. But we can only have that life when we have Jesus, who is life. In John chapter 14, verse 6, Jesus says, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. So there is no way you can go to the Father. There is no way you can go to God when you don't have Jesus, who is the way. He is the truth, and He is the life of God. So that life is what He came to give us. When you give your life to Jesus, you become a partaker of His life, the life of God for every humanity. But if you resist the truth and you reject Jesus, you are a partaker of death, the death of sin. And the Bible says all of us have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. Sin brought death, the death of the soul. It's a death of the human spirit. When the human spirit is dead, it cannot respond to the things of God. There are some people, they have some of their bodies that have cells, or some of the cells in the body are dead. When some cells in your body are dead, now what that means is that it ceases to function. The cells don't function the way God wants them to function. So, precious one, if a human being has the cells dead, he can have a stroke or withered hand. The hand is there, but it's not moving. But you see, the hand is there, but it's dead. The cells inside are not working. We have some people like that. Because they live in sin, they are dead from the presence of God. And when that death occurs, it means that you don't have access to the life of God. And when you don't have access to the life of God, it means that you don't have access to the eternal life. And when you don't have access to the eternal life, you don't have access to the glory of God, to the blessings of God. So you cannot even have access to God's revelations, the things about God that we see and know and understand. Because that comes through a spiritual perception. When you receive the life that God has for us, it comes through Jesus. He has given us life the day He gave us Jesus. Jesus is the life giver. In John 10:10, the Bible says, the thief does not come but for to steal and to kill and to destroy. But I've come so that you might have life and have it in abundance. So you see, that life that God wants you and I to have is a life of abundance, but it is the eternal life, and is it a life that only God had before Jesus came. And when Jesus came, He came to give us that life. So if you want to be a partaker of that life of God, you need the carrier of life, the giver of life in your life. You need Jesus Christ in your life, precious one. You need to receive Jesus. You need to accept Jesus. You need to give your life to Jesus. Receive that life into your spirit so that you know not death. Jesus actually explained that life to us. when he says, I'm the resurrection and the life. Jesus is the resurrection and he is the life of God. So if you and I, we want to enjoy God's kind of life, we need to have Jesus in our lives. When you have Jesus in your life, he will give you the life that God has for us. He said, he that have the Son, he has that life. And he that has not the Son of God has not life. And you might say, no, me, I don't have Jesus. I don't believe in Jesus, but I have life. You think you have life, but you are disconnected from God's life. You have a satanic life. You have a demonic life. You have a worldly life. You have a sinful life. No wonder you do the things that God doesn't want you to do. When you kill and lie and steal and commit adultery, you don't have the life of God. Because when we talk about the life of God, we are talking about a life that is receiving from God and obeying the things of God, obeying the commandment of God. Precious one, if you can receive the life of God, it will change your life and make you the kind of person that God created you to be. When you have Jesus in your life, he gives you a connection. He connects you to the Father. Because all of us were disconnected from the Father through sin. Yes, 1 John chapter 2, verse number 1 and 2, the Bible says, I write unto you a letter, little children, that you do not sin. But if anyone sin, we have an advocate with the Father. He is Jesus Christ the righteous, for he is the propitiation for our sins. So what we know about Jesus is that Jesus is the propitiation. And that means that he is the atoning sacrifice for our sins. So when you receive Jesus, he comes and beautify your life with the life of God. And that life of God means you begin to function the way God created you to function. We were created in the image of God. That means we're supposed to live a righteous life. But when man fall, they begin to disobey God. They started living in sin. Man took the nature of Satan. Because Satan brought sin. 1 John chapter 3 verse 8. The Bible says everyone that is committing sin is of the devil. Because the devil is the first person to have sinned. The reason the Son of God came is to destroy the works of the devil. So, you need to understand that when you sin, you are operating under the auspices of Satan. Now, to clarify it, that means you're an agent of Satan. Satan brought sin into the world. And you are doing it. You are promoting the work of the devil when you lie, when you kill, when you steal, when you commit adultery, when you are homosexual, when you are a lesbian. Because that which God said don't do, that is what you're doing. And why are you doing it? You're doing it because Satan gave you a sinful life to pursue. And that is what you are doing now. So when you give your life to Jesus, he connects you to the life of God. And the life of God is the life of righteousness. It's the life that connects to the Father, that sees God as the source and the creator. Ecclesiastes chapter 12 verse 1, the Bible says, remember not thy creator in the days of thy youth, before the evil days come not and the years draw nigh, when thou shalt say, I have no pleasure in them. So you need to understand, precious one, that you have a creator, God who created you. He's mighty and powerful, redeemer and deliverer. So when you have Jesus in your life, when you have his spirit in your spirit, when you have his life in your life, he connects you so that you don't live like Satan. Neither should you act like Satan. Neither should you behave like Satan, because you have received the life of God. So you disconnect from sin. When you receive Jesus, who is alive, he will sow a seed of righteousness in you. And that's the seed of the life of God. The life that God wants us to live. So verse 13, 1 John chapter 5, verse 13. The Bible says, these things have I written unto you that believe on the name of the Son of God, that ye may know that ye have eternal life, and that ye may believe on the name of the Son of God. So he wrote us these things. That's the Bible. The reason why the word of God was written is because God wants us to know what he has given to us, and that is eternal life. So we should not live a miserable life, or ordinary human being life. Oh, let us eat and drink because tomorrow we die. No, when you die, it's not over yet. Because in the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 12, verse 7, the Bible says, the dust shall return back to the earth as it was, and the spirit shall depart unto God who gave it. So the spirit, that is the life of God in you. In Genesis chapter 2, verse 7, the Bible says, the Lord God formed man from the dust of the ground, and he breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and the man became a living soul. So when you have the breath of God in you, you have the life of God in you. But when man sinned against God, they were disconnected from God. The Spirit of God was inside you, but you were disconnected from God. When you're disconnected from God, it means you cannot connect to God, but rather human beings were connected to Satan, and they started doing satanic and diabolical activities and sinful things. And that's the reason for all these things called LGBTQI+, lesbians, homosexuals, and gay people, because they are disconnected from God. They are not connected with Satan. They want to perform the enterprise of Satan. They want to disobey God and live their own kind of life. You know, when they know scripture, in Leviticus chapter 20, verse 13, the Bible says, if a man sleep with his fellow man the way he should sleep with a woman, both of them have committed an abomination. They shall surely be put to death, and their blood shall be upon their head. But you know what? Human beings are not connected to Satan. So they connive with Satan, so to disobey the word of God. Now, one of the missions of Satan is to make sure that human beings will live in disobedience. Meaning that the devil wants us to do everything to disobey God, so that the wrath of God will arise against human beings. So he has a doctrine that the Bible calls it the doctrine of Balaam, teaching people to disobey God in the book of Revelations. So when you disobey God, God is annoyed with you, then you can face the wrath of God. And that's how the devil destroys your life. So never you think Satan loves you. He's teaching you a way of being free, a way of living a diabolical life, and you think you are happy with it. You cannot be happy doing evil, because you're going to face the consequence of your sins. Jesus came to give us life. Satan came to give us death. So think of it, precious one, that God has given us life, but we chose not to walk in that life by rejecting Jesus, the giver of life. God wants you to enjoy his God kind of life. And that's why he gave us Jesus, so that Jesus will be our savior. But not many of us like Jesus. Not many of us want to walk with Jesus. So we have Satan that is introducing diabolical activities, lesbians, bisexual people. Of course, you know what a lesbian is. A woman sleeping with a woman. Then the L, the B is the bisexual. A man can sleep with a man. A man can sleep with a woman. He's a bisexual. And then LGBT, that's the transgender. When you go and change your gender status, making yourself somebody that God didn't create. Transgender, meaning that now we have a transgender woman, transgender man. God created you a man, you say you are in the wrong body. Some say that. You're not in the wrong body, you're having the wrong feelings. You're a man, you came in the body of a woman. And you say you are a woman, you came in the body of a man. So you're going to transgender, you transform your gender status. And you say, I'm in the wrong body. You're not in the wrong body. You're having the wrong feelings. Now the reason you're having the wrong feelings is because Satan has come to dwell in you. He has sown a seed of sinfulness in you. So you can have that wrong feeling. That's the reason you go for transgender. You need deliverance. Jesus has to deliver you. Otherwise, a thief can justify their actions. A murderer can justify his actions, because he too could say that he is in the wrong life. God wants us to have his life, the God kind of life. That is the life that Jesus gave to give us. Why do we reject that life and go in for diabolical life? We need the seed of God. The seed of God is the word of God. 1 John chapter 3 verse 9. The Bible says, whosoever is born of God has no sin, because his seed remaineth in him. And that seed is the word of God. The sower sows the seed in Matthew chapter 13. So right now, Jesus came to sow the seed of repentance, the seed of salvation, the seed of deliverance, the seed of righteousness through the word of God. In John John chapter 15 verse 3. The Bible says, you have been made whole through the words that are spoken unto you. So when the word of God comes to you, it makes you whole. When the word of God comes to you, it delivers you. It sets you free. Then you begin to enjoy the life of God. The life that God created for you to enjoy when he originally meant you to come into this world. So that seed will bring forth righteousness in you. You need to accept it and live the righteous life. Because whatever a man soweth, that is how he's going to reap. You reap what you sow. Galatians chapter 6 verse 7. Do not be deceived. Whatsoever a man soweth, that's what he's going to reap. There is a place of judgment for you and I. That is why we need to accept the life that God has given to us. God doesn't want us to perish in our sins. Ecclesiastes chapter 12 verse 13 and 14. The Bible says, let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep his commandment, for this is the whole duty of man. For God shall bring every work into judgment with every secret thing, whether it be good or whether it be evil. You need to fear God. When you have the fear of God in you, it will keep you from doing evil. To fear God means you have some kind of reverential attitude towards the name of God and the things of God. You are probably listening to me because you have the fear of God in you. Those who do not have the fear of God might not even have time to listen to the word of God. 1 Corinthians chapter number 1 verse 18. The Bible says the preaching of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing. But to us who have been saved is the power of God. Sometimes we might be preaching good, but it can sound foolishness for you. Why? Because you are perishing. May God's word never sound foolishness for you. Because it is the deadness of your conscience. When your conscience is dead from the presence of God, God's word doesn't make sense to you. You wouldn't even like to hear it. When Adam and Eve ate the forbidden fruit in Genesis chapter 3, we find out that they heard the voice of God walking in the cool of the day. And the Bible says, Adam said, I heard your voice walking in the cool of the day, and I hid myself because I was afraid of my nakedness. He was ashamed of God because he became naked. Because he was dead, the glory left him. So he discovered his nakedness. May you not die from the presence of God. May you not die from the things of God. May you not die from the glory of God. May you not die from the word of God. Because God's word is the life. When you reject the word, you are rejecting life. In the book of Deuteronomy, we find out here, Deuteronomy chapter 30, let's read the Bible small, verse 15. It says, see, I've said before thee this day life and good and death and evil. God is talking. He said, he have said before you this day life. Life. He said life and death. Life, which is also good. Then he said death, which is also evil. Verse 16, in that I commanded this day to love the Lord thy God, to walk in his ways and to keep his commandments and his statutes and his judgments, that thou mayest live and multiply, and the Lord thy God shall bless thee in the land where thou goest to possess. So God says he command you to love the Lord thy God. When you love him, you walk in his ways, you can obey him, and you can do his will. And it shall be well with you. So God says that he has said before you. So that God gives you a choice. God is good. He loves you. He created you. But he doesn't force you or compel you to do his will. Psalm 100 verse 3. The Bible says, know ye that it is the Lord. It is he that has made us and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. So we are made by God. We are created by God. We don't own ourselves. He made us. He created us. He gave us a life. And that life is in Jesus. And it's in discovery of his word. And he says, choose that life. He says, in that I commanded this day to love the Lord thy God, to walk in his ways and to keep his commandments and his statutes and his judgment, that thou mayest live and multiply, and the Lord thy God shall bless thee in the land whither thou goest to possess it. So that is the life we're talking about. That's the life we're talking about. God has given us life. That life is to obey his commandments, is to receive the word of God into your heart so that you will keep God's word. When you have God's word and you keep God's word and you're obeying God's word, you are living the life. You are expressing the life of God in you. It's only a human being that can express the life of God. A dog cannot express the life of God. A cow, a cattle cannot express the life of God. But it's a human being, because he's the one that is created in the image of God. So God says, when you obey his commandments, he has set before you life. Verse 17, but if thy heart turn away so that thou wilt not hear, but shall be drawn away and worship other gods and serve them. He says, if your heart turned away from God and you will not hear, and you are drawn to serve other gods. Deuteronomy chapter 30, verse 17. Verse 18, he said, I denounce unto you this day that ye shall surely perish, and that ye should not prolong your days upon the land whither thou goest to Jordan to possess it. You understand what the Bible says? That when you disobey God, he says, I denounce unto you this day that ye shall surely perish. To perish means to be destroyed. To perish means to end up in hellfire. To perish means you die before your time. To perish means destruction come your way. So God is sending forth his word to deliver you. To perish means you fall sick. Like this pandemic that has destroyed so many lives. Yes, perish. Because they rejected God. So the devil is attacking so many. We are perishing gradually. Yet we don't seem to come to ourselves and accept the truth of God. You need Jesus right now. He loves you. He cares for you. He doesn't want you to perish. He came to give you a life. If you will accept that life, you shall live and not die. You will not die before your time. You will not be afflicted by the devil. Satan will not destroy you before your time. You will have God to be your savior. You will have eternal life. When it comes to death, God can decide to call you when your time is up. But you'll not die in timely death. You will enjoy the long life, the life of the Father, the life that God came to give you. I want you to understand this, that God has given you life. Receive that life now, and it shall be well with you. I want to pray with you, precious one. Father, we thank you because you love your children. You have spoken to us that you have given us life. We pray that that life will be their portion. That they will accept your life. That they will live and to enjoy that life. Lord, we pray for as many as are receiving your word. With a good heart, that the word of the Lord will transform them. That you will touch their lives and forgive their sin. For you are the Lord that forgives. We thank you, Jesus, for giving us life. Amen. God bless you, precious one. My name is Prophet Apostle Ezekiel Melchizedek from the Salvation Christian Church Worldwide. I am the presiding minister. We are at SCC Weja in Accra, Ghana. You see the numbers on your screen now. You can call or WhatsApp me for prayer or counseling. It shall be well with your soul. God be with your soul. I believe in that we shall meet again in the precious name of Jesus through the glory of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. The Lord be gracious unto you. The Lord continue to empower you so that you will excel. Have a great day. The blessing of the Lord goes with you. The glory of God goes with you. You are not the same person because God's word has changed you. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. We give you praise.
Hello, precious one. I hope you're blessed by this broadcast. You want to give your life to Jesus Christ for the first time? I want you to pray this prayer of salvation after me. Say, dear Lord Jesus Christ, I confess you as my Lord and my Savior. Forgive my sins and wash me with the blood of Jesus. Write my name in the book of life. I thank you for saving me. In Jesus' name, amen. If you just pray that prayer, I want you to know that you're born again. Now you're a child of God. You live your life in consonance as a born-again Christian. If you are blessed by this broadcast, tell us. Let us know where you're watching. You can also give us your name and prayer request. We are praying for you. Contact +233-240-59-8420. Call or WhatsApp. Email EzekielMelchizedek@gmail.com. God bless you.
Something more than